mayong hapon sa kanan. Dapat ang Lord Governor, Kuya Bob Edwin I. Hubahid, First District Representative of Davao del Norte, Congressman Pantaleon Diaz Alvarez. We also have Congressman Ronnie L. Ong, Treasurer of Partido Reforma, Honorable Arnel T. Tacom City Mayor, Honorable Dr. Alan L. Leon, and Tacom City Councilor, Honorable Attorney Anna Alvarez. To our provincial officials and employees, esteemed guests, our media partners, people of Davao del Norte, it is our immense pleasure to have the presence of the second highest official of the country, the Vice President of the Republic of the Philippines, and presidential candidate for the 2022 Philippine General Election. Ladies and gentlemen, Vice President Maria Leonor Leni Gerona Robredo. Welcome po to Davao del Norte, and as we say it in our local language, maayong pagdayon sa Davao del Norte. We are privileged because we have the opportunity to ask questions to Vice President. We have our media partners who will join us this afternoon for a press conference. But before we begin, let's hear the message first from our very dynamic First District Representative of Davao del Norte. Ladies and gentlemen, Congressman Pantaleon Diaz.
Vice President Leni. Partido Reforma has always sought to represent the better ideals in politics, mindful of the limitations imposed by far from perfect world, but faithful to the aim of attaining good governance through reform as its constant guiding North Star. Given the challenges that the nation must confront due to the pandemic, the resulting economic crisis, and the spillover adverse consequences in the everyday lives of our people, we initiated an urgent campaign called We Need a Leader 2022. There is no doubt that after a thorough search, we found a once-in-a-generation candidate, a rare gem who devoted his entire life to exceptional public service, risked life and limb for his countrymen, cleaned the ranks of the police force when he led that institution, fought against corruption, and advocated consistently and credibly for good governance. And when he became a senator, he authored important laws, including but not limited to free irrigation for our farmers, national ID system to simplify government processes, and increase in the pay of military and uniformed personnel to support our heroes. He is also the guardian of the national budget, protecting the treasury from those who seek to plunder it. He knows that corruption is not a victimless crime, and with every peso lost, Filipinos tragically have less healthcare, education, infrastructure, and economic opportunities. Last but not least, his advocacy for budget reform is the key to bringing development to the countryside, empowering LGUs by giving them more funds and handing over to them the ability to efficiently and effectively respond to the needs of their constituents is key to long-lasting development. Senator Ping Lacson is the best, and our leaders on the ground have echoed that sentiment time and again. even supporters of our candidates agree. And under ideal circumstances, they want to campaign and vote for him and see him lead the country. He is the most qualified to be president. But the electoral terrain in 2022 is far from ideal. The faith had other plans. Time and context framed the narrative of 2022 in a way that gave traction, rightly or wrongly, to other candidacies instead. This is a difficult fact which takes courage to admit. Right now, two candidates have pulled away from the pack, and while the candidate second in ranking still lags far behind from the front runner, it is evident that her campaign has gained. Continues to gain significant traction. There is much potential there. She has also shown that she represents ideals which are substantially in line with the aims of Partido Reforma to reform government and provide a better future for the Filipinos. Our ground leaders have expressed their wish to participate in that brave calling. And that is why a hard choice must be made. With a heavy heart, many members of Partido Reforma are constrained to consider a candidate other than their first choice. We reasonably believe that the only realistic option at this point, with roughly a month and a half left, is to converge with Leni Robredo's campaign. Together, we will pursue the realization of our collective aspirations to improve the chances of ordinary Filipinos at a better life. The Reforma members and officers concerned, they positively but realistically view the opportunity to help ensure that the Leni Robredo campaign is strengthened and further represented by additional sectors of society, especially from those in Mindanao, our home, which runs the risk of being neglected again when President Rodrigo Duterte steps down from office. We respect the choice of our members and officers. They are not pink, but they are reformists, and they are for Leni Robredo. The fight for good governance and a better tomorrow for our people has never been and never will be limited to a single color. I personally have also made a decision. With time still left, but admittedly not a lot of it, decisive action is necessary. We must respond to the demands of patriotism requiring us to set aside personal preferences, the end goal being collective victory for good governance, a better future for Filipinos, and a strong and progressive nation. We need a leader. And for the 2022 presidential elections, given all these considerations, and the crisis we have to overcome, that leader is a woman. Her name is Leni Robredo.
Daghang salamat, Congressman Pantaleon Diaz Alvarez.
The next one to give his statement is our visionary and progress-oriented governor, ang Kuya ng Masa, Kuya Bob Edwin I. Hubahin.
Magandang hapon po, Davao del Norte. At lahat ng empleyado ng Kapitolyo. Alam po ng lahat kung gaano po kalaki ang aking paghanga kay Senator King Lacson. Dahil po para sa akin, he possesses the qualities of a good leader to lead the country. He has a wide experience in politics at wala pong bahid ng korupsyon ang kanyang paninindihan. Subalit, kung pagbabasihan natin ang survey, he has a slim chance of winning. Pinakinggan po natin ang boses ng mga tao at ng mga leader ng Davao del Norte. Sa dalawang presidensya balls na nangunguna sa kahit anong survey, pinili po natin suportahan si Vice President Lini Robredo, ma'am. Dahil kagaya ni Senator Lacson, wala pong bahid ng korupsyon ang kanyang paninilbihan noon pa man at hanggang ngayon. Inisip po natin ang kapakanan ng ating mamamayan. So we choose the leader who will help us realize the aspiration of the Filipino people. Maraming salamat po. God bless us all.
Daghang salamat, Kuya Bob Edwin I. Hubahin. At this juncture, we will have our press conference. For our first set of questions will be for Congressman Pantaleon Diaz Alvarez. The first question will be coming from Marlon Ramos of Inquirer. Sir?
Magandang hapon. Speaker, just po pass through kung paano po yung naging discussion nyo sa party, within the party, and also did you consult with the center team before you made the decision?
Hindi kami nakapag-usap na ni Senator Ping personal, no? Pero through text messages, communicate po kami. Ngayon, dito naman sa decision na ito, ay nag-usap-usap po kami lahat ng mga mayors at mga leaders namin dito sa probinsya. At yun, napagkasunduan nga na susuportahan namin ang kandidatura ni Vice President Lenny Robredo.
Sir, will you try to convince Senator Ping to also join the rest of your party in supporting him?
Alam mo, personal decision kasi yan. Hindi po madaling yung decision na yon. At ako naman ay ayaw ko personally na kumbinsihin si Senator Ping. At siguro mas maganda kung hayaan natin siyang magdesisyon kung ano talaga yung para sa bayan na mas maganda.
Thank you, sir.
Alright, thank you so much. The next question will be coming from GMA Online, Ms. Dines Capanti.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Dineska from GMA News.
At hindi naman siguro pinaka-critic, no? Although, aminin ko, naging nakikritik din ako kay Vice President. Marami rin ako nasabi nito maganda at humihingi ako ng tawad, ma'am. Ito kasi, para sa akin, personal, bakit nakapagpasya akong sumuporta kay Lenny Robredo? Ito yun. Ang unang laban na sinagihan ko noong dekada 80. Nasa Ateneo Law School ako noon. At naalala ko pa rin, sumasama kami sa mga marcha-marcha doon sa kalye para tuldukan ang rehiming diktadurang Marcos. Kasama ko. Yun ang unang laban. Marcos versus Cory. Yun yung snap elections noong dekada 80. Ngayon, pangalawang laban. Kaya lang, pareho pa rin. Marcos, nagbago lang ito versus Lenny. At ayoko naman na yung pinaglaban ko noon ay hindi ko na ipaglalaban ngayon. Kaya para sa akin, gusto ko lang ituloy yung laban, yung unang laban na sinagihan ko, itutuloy ko sa pangalawang laban na ito, Marcos versus Lenny.
We have a follow-up question from Maris Ubeda of Rapper.
I want to direct my question to VP Lenny Robredo. I know that Congressman Alvarez has apologized to him, but you know, I did cover him in the House and hi sir. And you know, once upon a time he even mulled an impeachment complaint against you. So I want to ask you, ma'am, how are you able to get past that very complicated political history with the former speaker?
Ano kasi Mara, unang-una, speaker, you do not need to apologize. Kasi over the course of our service naman to the country mo, meron mga bagay na hindi talaga pagkakasunduan. Hindi na yung mga magkakampi, hindi naman expected na nagkakasundo sa lahat na bagay. Pero kami, wala naman kami personal. Wala sa aming personal na disagreement. When I filed my certificate of candidacy in October of 2021, I filed as an independent. Sinabi ko sa inyo na yun yung aking ang pinakamensahe ng pag-file ko as an independent, bukas ako sa lahat. Bukas ako sa lahat as long as nagkakaisa ang aming hangarin para ayusin yung ating bansa. Yung reforma naman, pareho yung aming hangarin to fix this country through good governance. And nagkakasundo kami na pareho yung aming mga pinaglalaban. Meron siguro kaming hindi pinagkasunduan in the past and most probably hindi kami aligned sa lahat na bagay. Pero ang parati ko din sinasabi na ang pinakamahalaga yung mga bagay na pinagkakasunduan nyo, hindi yung mga bagay na hindi nyo pinagkakasunduan. And in this case, pareho din kami ni Speaker Alvarez na naniniwala na yung bansa natin, yung pinaka-interest natin sa election na ito, ano yung pinaka-makakabuti para sa bansa natin.
Our next question will be from Adjo Alimario of CNN.
Pwede ko bang sagutin din yung katanungan ni Mara? Sa totoo lang, Mara, wala naman akong sabihin mo ayaw kay VP Lenny. Nung time na ako ay speaker, lahat ginawa ko para protektahan at depensahan yung ating Pangulo. Kaya ako naman, ganun talaga ang ugali ko. Pag dinidepensahan ko yung kasama ko, I'm willing to take the bullets. Kahit magalit ka na sa akin, kaya maraming nagagalit sa akin noon. Dahil nga, ina-arbor ko yung away. Pero wala, ganun talaga ako. Yan yung nature ng personality ko. Magkaibigan tayo, may kaaway ka, pwede kong arborin yung away na yan para protektahan kita. Ganun lang kasimple yun.
So once again, The next one to give a question will be Angel Alimarios.
Hi, ma'am. Good afternoon po. Ma'am, I know this is the first time to enter what may be considered the Duterte country, the Davao region. Ma'am, some officials have been pushing for a, you know, Robredo-Duterte tandem. What is your take on that?
Ako klaro naman from the very start. From the very start until now, until the very end, ang Vice President ko si Kiko Pangilinan. Hindi na iiwasan na, hindi naman ngayon lang election, pero kahit ng mga nakaraang election, may mga supporters na iba yung choices at iba yung pinupush na mga combinations. Pero as far as I am concerned, as far as yung official campaign structure is concerned, ang aking Vice President until the very end, Kiko Pangilinan. Saka ano pala, hindi to first time na pumasok ako dito sa Davao region. In fact, during the course of the 6 years that I was Vice President, we have had programs here. During the pandemic, we have been helping a lot of hospitals in the Davao region. Ano sunod-sunod na mga sakuna, whether Baguio o mga lindol, parati kami nagpapadala ng teams dito to do relief operations.
Alright, thank you so much. The next one to ask question will be Gerard De La Peña of TV5.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, VP. Speaking of your projects po, biniyaga na po ng COMELEC yung pag-resume ng Angat Buhay programs. Now, ano po yung reaction niyo po sa pagbayag ng COMELEC? And then, ano po yung mga projects na siguro po priority namin na ituloy?
Yung exemption kasi hiningi namin very specific. Yung exemption sa hiningi namin for medical assistance, for bayanihan i-consulta, for vaccine express, saka yung swab cam. So, dun lang kami limited. Limited lang yung extension dun sa apat na projects na yun. Pero sobrang relieved kami. Sobrang relieved kami kasi ang dami na namin nakukuha ng requests for assistance na hindi namin natulunan. Dahil wala pa yung decision yung COMELEC. Now, pwede na namin i-resume.
Ma'am, on another matter po, how are you taking po yung overwhelming support, especially nung Sunday sa Pasig, and then pagpunta niyo po na may Isiha, Tarlac, hindi ka po sa Davao. How are you taking this support po?
Kami talagang humbled and grateful. Hindi namin inaasahan, lalong-lalo kaninang umaga. Lalong-lalo kaninang umaga, hindi namin inaasahan sa Digos na ganun na klase ng suporta yung makukuha, na ganun kadaming supporters na andito. Also, kahit kay Gov Edwin, nagpapasalamat din kami and the rest of the Davao del Norte family, pati kay Speaker. Kasi kahit dito sa Davao del Norte, nagulat ako pagpasok ko ng Capitol kanina kasi may supporters. So ano to, laging paalala sa amin na hindi kami nag-iisa sa laban. And this fight is really worth fighting.
Alright. So the last question will be coming from Janica Delight Villanueva of PTV Davao del Norte.
Good afternoon po, VP. So I am from PTV Davao del Norte, Channel 48, the official TV station of Davao del Norte. So my question po is related sa province of Davao del Norte. So one of the pressing and longest issues in our province is insurgency po. The present administration, Kuya Gov's administration, made sure that we apply the methods of the NDF-ELCAP po in combating and suppressing insurgency. And our province also established a holistic approach wherein we provide rehabilitation for former rebel surrenderees, paving the way for more rebels to restore their trust in the government and to return to the folds of the law. So Kuya Gov's administration po already has a good head start in resolving this issue. So my question po is, how will Lenny Robredo's administration support, aid, and improve this endeavor? And what are your plans po to put an end to communist armed conflict?
I think I have mentioned this several times in past interviews already, na yung whole of nation, whole of government approach. And the governor has been doing a lot of tremendous things for the province. Actually, first time ko si Governor na-meet, and I was congratulating him for all the good work that he has done in the past 3 years. including the anti-insurgency program of the province. Dapat talaga ito yung track na it is not a purely militaristic approach that will solve the insurgency issue. But government is on the right track. Meaning to say, tama na convergent siya ng lahat ng mga services ng iba't ibang mga ahensya para matugunan yung root cause. Yung root cause ng problema. Kasi kahit mag-militaristic approach ka, kung hindi mo na resolve yung root cause, mabalik-balik lang siya. Yung aking disagreement with the program yung red tagging. Yung NTS. Ang palagay ko hindi lang dahil na-red tag ako. Pero palagay ko yung tagging kasi na-compromise niya yung confidence ng tao sa programa. And sa programa nito kailangan mo yung tangan mo yung cooperation ng tao kasi yun nga eh kaya nga whole of nation approach siya kasi hindi lang gobyerno yung magre-resolve nito pero tayo lahat. And kung meron mga bank nakaka-erode ng tiwala ng tao, ang nagsasuffer yung programa. Pero what Davao del Norte has been doing in the last 3 years as far as the anti-insurgency program is concerned is something that we should all aspire for.
Thank you so much. There is also a question from Jacob Lazaro of One News.
Hi ma'am. Follow-up lang po ako dun sa support na nakukuha nyo. Aside naman from the people's support sa mga rallies, going to the political naman, you've also been getting a lot of, a slew of political endorsements, especially locally. Now, how important or how will this help you sa campaign nyo, especially in local endorsement, since magsa-start na po yung campaigning for local officials tomorrow?
Malaking-malaking bagay siya. Malaking-malaking bagay. Kasi halimbawa dito, without the governor's endorsement, without Kong Alvarez endorsement, paano kami makakakuha ng suporta from all other local officials? Siyempre, we value the help of all our volunteers. We think they're doing a tremendous job in helping us with the campaign. Pero kahit yung volunteers will agree na pag ang suporta galing sa local officials, everything else becomes easier. Talagang ano, sobrang laking headway ito. Sobrang laking boost in our campaign that we're getting the support of this part of Davao. Lalong-lalo na kasi in 2016, natalo ako Mr. of the Year. So bago itong, parang ano siya, hindi lang, ang epekto nito hindi lang dito. Pero I am sure because of the coming out of Speaker Alvarez, of the governor, and all the local officials here, including Congressman T, saka si Congressman O, mas maglalakas loob yung ibang local officials to follow suit. Ganun naman talaga yung laban. Pag nagsisimula ka na medyo dehado, it takes a lot of courage to come out in the open. And I'm just so thankful na Speaker Alvarez and the governor has been very brave in doing this thing. Kasi ano talaga to? Even the volunteers have been telling us na mabuti na lang na mag-support na si ganito kasi mas makakabuelo kami. So ano talaga? I'm very grateful ka.
Thank you so much, and that ends our press conference. Daghan kay salamat sa our media partners and of course to our esteemed guest, Vice President Lenny Robredo, Davao del Norte Governor Kuya Gov Edwin I. Hubay, First District Representative of Davao del Norte, Congressman Pantaleon Diaz Alvarez, Congressman Ronnie L. Ong, Congressman Arnel T., Taguig City Mayor Dr. Alan L. Leon, and Taguig City Councilor Honorable Attorney Anna Alvarez. So we'd also like to ask our guest to stand for our photo opportunity. Daghang salamat, mabuhay ang ating Vice Presidente. Vice President Lenny Robredo, and of course, Partido Reforma.